In this video, I'm going to show you how to connect to an OPC server and browse for data using the PI OPC Client Tool. So right now we're at the point where we have installed the PI interface for OPC DA, but we haven't configured any instance of the interface yet. And before we configure anything, we're going to want to make sure that our PI interface is going to be able to connect to the OPC server and access data on the OPC server. We also want to make sure that that data is currently good. And finally, we might want to choose which data we're going to be collecting using the PI interface. So we can do all this using the PI OPC Client Tool, which is a tool that's installed when you install the PI interface for OPC DA. So let me start up that application. One thing to note here is that if your OPC server is installed on a different computer, you're going to need to run the PI OPC Client Tool using an account that has the proper DCOM permissions to access that OPC server. As a general rule, you always want to start the PI OPC Client Tool using the account that's eventually going to be used to run the PI interface for OPC DA's service. So let me show you how to do that. First, let's bring up the Start menu and search for the PI OPC Client Tool. So here, instead of clicking on it, we're going to right-click on it. And then, depending on your local policies, you might have the option Run as Different User. And this is what you're going to want to select. However, it's possible that this hasn't been enabled, so what you can do is first pin the application to the taskbar. So I'm going to show you the second way. Once it's pinned to the taskbar, what you can do is hold down the Shift key and then right-click on the application. And then you'll have the option Run as Different User. So my account is a local account. And once I put in the password, the application starts up under that account. So the PI OPC Client Tool is actually fairly similar to the PI interface for OPC DA in the sense that it's also an OPC client. So its primary function is to connect to an OPC server and access data on it. But the difference is that it comes with this graphical user interface, meaning that the user can actually browse the OPC server and see the data updating in real time. So this is not only useful when you're first configuring the PI interface, it's actually fairly useful if you ever need to troubleshoot it. Let's say your PI interface for OPC DA has stopped collecting data. You can use the PI OPC Client Tool to make sure that there's nothing wrong with your OPC server. Alright, so the first thing we're going to want to do is connect to the node that is hosting our OPC server. And as you can see here on the top left corner, the default node that we're going to connect to is the local host. So if your OPC server is not local, you're going to need to change this. So you can do this by clicking on the ellipses up here. That's going to allow you to browse your network for the OPC server node. If you know the IP address or host name of your node, you can actually just type it into this field here. Since my OPC server is local, I'm going to leave this as default. Next, I'm going to click on the Connect to Node button, which is here. And this is going to populate the OPC servers field, which is located here. So this lists all the OPC servers that the PI OPC client was able to find on the node. Next, I can choose which OPC server I want to connect to and press on the Connect to OPC Server button. This is going to populate the Server Status field, which is located down here. So this basically confirms that we were successfully able to connect to our OPC server. You can also see the server current state, which is running. This is what you want to see if your OPC server is healthy. So it's possible that you were not able to connect to your OPC server. This could mean a couple of things. It can mean that the OPC server is not running or is not available on the network. And it can also mean that the OPC server is running, but you just don't have access to it using the PI OPC Client Tool. Okay, so we have connected to our OPC server. Next, we're going to want to browse for data. So before we do that, we're actually going to have to create a group. So you might be asking, what is a group? It's sort of something that exists with the OPC DA standard. It's essentially how OPC clients organize the data that they're asking or requesting from the OPC server. So on the PI system, we organize data by tags. For OPC DA, these are organized by items. And again, an OPC client needs to organize these items under groups. So to create our group, we're going to have to press on the Add a Group button, which is up here. And so this brings up the Add Group dialog. And we see that we have a lot of options, but since we're primarily using the PI OPC Client Tool to validate the data on the OPC server, these don't really matter too much for us. So I'm going to just hit Create. Next, we're going to want to add items to our group. So we're going to do that using the Browse OPC Server button, which is located here. And this is going to open up the Add Item dialog. So we see our OPC server listed, but we don't see any items yet. And the reason for this is that we need to browse the OPC server using the browse options that are up here. So typically, OPC servers organize their items under a hierarchy. And so the easiest way to list that hierarchy is simply to press the List button, which is located here. This is going to load the entire hierarchy under the OPC server, and it's going to allow you to drill down the hierarchy, and when you select a branch in the hierarchy, you're going to be able to see all the items under that branch listed on the right over here. So it's possible that your OPC server actually has a very large hierarchy, so listing your hierarchy this way would actually take a pretty long time. So I'm going to show you another way you could do this, but first I'm going to clear the hierarchy using the Clear button located here. All right, so let's say you have a really big hierarchy and you don't want to list the entire thing at once. You can actually select the Manual option, which is located here. This is going to allow you to simply load the very first level of the hierarchy. So as you can see, we only have the very first level. If I want to drill down, I'm going to have to select my branch and hit the List button again. So again, this is helpful if your OPC server has a very large hierarchy and you don't want to load the entire thing at once. Okay, so now I'm going to show you a third option. Sometimes OPC servers don't have their items listed under a hierarchy at all. In that case, you need to use the Flat option, which is here. This is basically going to list all the items for an OPC server on the right, without having them organized at all. All right, so I'm going to clear this again and list my hierarchy how I did with the first method. Now I want to add items. What I need to do is select an item, and this is going to populate the Items Properties window, which is down here. And the most important property is the item ID. This is the unique identifier of the item on the OPC server, and this is what the OPC client needs in order to request the correct data from the OPC server. So I'm going to want to hit the Add button to add this item to my group. Obviously, this would take pretty long if you wanted to add several items, so you can add items in bulk using these buttons, Select All and Add Selected. So I'm just going to select a couple other items. And hit Add Selected. Alright, so one last thing. It's possible that your OPC server doesn't support browsing at all, which means when you try to find your items, you're not going to be able to find anything. So it's still possible to use the OPC Client Tool to confirm that your data is valid, even if you are not able to browse. So I'm going to show you how to do that. First, I'm going to clear everything that's in this dialog. So all you need to know in order to add an item to a group is the item ID. So as long as you know that, you can type it in. And then you can add any tag name you want. It doesn't really matter. And then again, you hit the Add button. So as you can see, I was able to add this item without being able to browse the OPC server. All right, so if you're satisfied with your items in your group, All you have to do is hit OK at the bottom. Okay, so now we have connected to our OPC server, we have created our group, and we've added items to our group. But we're still not getting any data. And that's because we haven't told the OPC client how to ask for data from the OPC server. So there's a couple of different ways that we can request the data, but for simplicity's sake, we're simply going to use the pull method, which is using this button up here. This is going to request the data from the OPC server every second. Okay, so this brings up the polling group dialog, and we can now see that we have values, quality, and timestamps for all of our items. So what are we making sure of? Well, we want to make sure that the value is good, it makes sense for the data that we're requesting, that the timestamp is current, but there's also this third column here, quality. This is again a property that comes with the OPCDA standard. It's essentially how the OPC server tells the OPC client if the data that it's sending is any good. So we want to make sure that the quality of our data is good. So that's basically it. We've confirmed that we have good quality data using our PI OPC client tool. There's just one last thing I'd like to show you, and that's the fact that you don't actually need the PI OPC client tool to do this. You can actually use any OPC client to confirm that your data is good. So oftentimes, when vendors sell OPC servers, it will come with an OPC client that you can use. But I'm also actually going to show you a different client that comes with the PI interface for OPCDA. And that's the PI OPC tool. This is actually the predecessor of the PI OPC client tool. So as you can see, it doesn't have as nice of a graphical user interface, but it essentially does the same thing. So I'm quickly going to go over the same steps that I did with the PI OPC client tool in the PI OPC tool. So as you'll remember, our first step is to connect to our node. Once again, the default node is the local host. So if I simply go to the drop-down menu for the server name, I'm going to see the servers that are installed locally. All right, the next step, as you'll remember, is to add a group. So I simply need to create group name and hit create. Next, I'm going to want to browse the OPC server. So if I hit list servers tags, I will get the hierarchy. And then I can drill down the hierarchy and find the item that I want to look at. If I double click on the item, I will get the tag properties. Once again, we have the item ID here. So I simply need to press add to group. And I now have that item in my group. Finally, I need to tell the OPC client how to access data from the OPC server. So I'm just going to hit refresh, and now I see that I have a good value, good timestamp, and good quality. All right, so now we have confirmed using two OPC clients that we have good data on our OPC server. So our next step is now going to be to configure an instance of the PI interface for OPCDA, and that's what we're going to do in the next video.